Hey, let's talk about love, why don't we? L-O-V-E. What's it mean to you, and what's it been to you in your life? How do you create and experience love? So we're going to explore some thoughts and some ideas. This is Debbi Dachinger, the Dare to Dream radio show. If you want to sign up for my free everything, free newsletters, free inspirational videos, and free amazing freaking interviews with the masters who walk on this planet, do it. You'll get all the links. It's deborahdachinger.com, D-E-B-O-R-A-H-D-A-C-H-I-N-G-E-R. So love, which is another shape. Boodum, boodum, boodum. First stage of love generally is attraction. Yes, attraction. The law of attraction says, basically, to be attractive, you have to be authentic. So how cool is it? You know when you hang out with somebody and they just so are who they are? How attractive is that? I mean, actually, there's not a lot of identities going on. There's not a lot of crapola. It's just like, bada boom, baby, here I am. And they're very much at peace with themselves. And people find that usually very charismatic. So, law of attraction, to be attractive, you got to be authentic. And what makes a person attractive? Well, nothing's more beautiful than being genuine and real. So check out how you feel you're doing in that area. Next, at some point, the act of love that we experience, there's some kind of a communion. And communion is basically, it's empathy. It's unity. It's closeness. It's intimacy. Intimacy. I like that the word in is in it, right? Because it's like into you, intimacy. So it's contact, basically, with soul. Soul and soul. Oh, soul and soul. Boom, boom. Communion is the sharing of spirit, and it's the basis of trust. So how about surrender? How about non-attachment? Because those are kind of very interesting words when you're talking about love, because some people like to become very attached. But what about surrender? Because surrender actually occurs when we relinquish the ego's last claims to being separate, right? We're not separate from anything, really, at all. Surrender and non-attachment open the door to the miraculous, because miracles, miracles exist outside the realm of I, me, mine. So non-attachment, surrender it all. There's a really beautiful definition of realness through love in Marguerite Williams' beautiful book, The Velveteen Rabbit. May I read it to you? Just a little excerpt. So beautiful. And here is the quote. What is real? Asked the rabbit one day. Does it mean having that buzz inside of you and a stick-out handle? Real isn't how you were made, said the skin horse. It's something that happens to you when a child loves you for a long time, not just to play with, but really loves you. Then you become real. Does it hurt? Asked the rabbit. Sometimes, said the skin horse, for he was always truthful. When you are real, you don't mind being hurt. Does it happen all at once, like being wound up? He asked, a bit by bit. Doesn't happen all at once, said the skin horse. You become. It takes a long time. That's why it doesn't often happen to people who break easily, or who have sharp edges, or who have to be carefully kept. Generally, by the time you are real, most of your hair has been loved off, and your eyes drop out, and you get loose in the joints and very shabby. But those things don't matter at all, because once you are real, you can't be ugly, except to people who don't understand. Once you are real, you can't become unreal again. It lasts for always. That's from The Velveteen Rabbit. And also another quote from Osho. Osho, who was asked, why is love so essential for spiritual growth? And by the way, before I go into this, you may be asking, why is she even talking about love? Well, that's because I'm doing a six-week series of interviews with Master Theta Healer. Hello, Karen Abrams. If you haven't experienced her, she's amazing. And if you can't listen to the calls live on the radio, and I am award-winning and syndicated on 5-6 stations now, then just go to my website and sign up, DeborahDachinger.com. You'll get all the replays for free and can listen at your leisure. But that's why we're talking about love, the idea of love, and you can share too. And I hope if this is impacting you or encouraging you, let me know. So Osho said about why love is so essential for spiritual growth, that love is very essential. You have to lose yourself to gain yourself. Love is the only possibility of losing yourself totally. When you are lost totally, then you will be able to remember who you, excuse me, no glasses, what you have done, not who you have done. I don't think Osho would have said that. What you have done. It's like a fish which has always lived in the ocean. It will never become aware of the ocean and the benediction of it. It has to be caught in a net. A fisherman has to come to take it out, throw it on the shore. Only on the shore, in the hot sun, will it remember for the first time. Although it has lived for years in the ocean, it was oblivious, completely oblivious of the ocean. Now the thirst, the heat, makes it mindful of the ocean. A great longing arises to go back to the ocean. It makes every effort to jump back into the ocean. Love is a must for spiritual growth, and moreover, love functions as a mirror. It is very difficult to know yourself unless you have looked at your face in the eyes of someone who loves you. Just as you have to look into the mirror to see your physical face, you have to look in the mirror of love to see your spiritual face. Love is a spiritual mirror. It nourishes you. It integrates you. It makes you ready for the inner journey. It reminds you of your original face. Some thoughts and ideas about love. And if you have not yet, get my best-selling book, Dare to Dream, This Life Counts. It's on my website, Amazon, and also at all bookstores. It teaches you everything you need to know about making those dreams come true. And if you want to be on the radio, I have an amazing, amazing product for that too. Very inexpensive, very simple, and it's changing lives. So there's so much to do, everything from free to very inexpensive and still all life-changing. DeborahDachinger.com, Dare to Dream Radio. Don't just dare to dream, dare to make all your dreams your reality and live life, live this moment, live today.